This is the patient. Yes, I can certainly see that they have experienced a grave spiritual injury. Oh, it seems they're waking up. Hello. Hello. It's okay, there is nothing to worry about. Nothing. This may be a matter of great concern elsewhere. Fortunately, I am entirely equipped to help you with this situation. Yes, all you need to do is lay there and relax, okay? I will take care of the healing. Before we begin, I just need you to drink a little bit of this pure water. This water has been cleansed of both physical and spiritual impurities, and will help guide the healing throughout your body to the places that need it the most. I will sip from it first to ensure to you that it is safe, okay? This water this cleansing process is charge the air. What I'm going to do is introduce a bit of smoke into the air, and this particular smoke will help the healing energy from me to you in a more efficient manner, focused manner. So I'm just going to light this and give it a moment to catch. This incense is going to fill the air around us. It's going to fill the air around us with a soup. see how the spirals of the smoke are reacting to your spiritual injury. Yes, I can certainly sense that something tumultuous has taken place. I only need a bit more of this smoke. For this part, I'm only going to be observing your energetic field and diagnosing just what exactly I need to do to repair any imbalances or injuries. Okay, all you need to do is rest. Just rest and relax, and I will take care of you. Okay. I will begin from the top of your energy barrier. Balance is incidental or afflicted, but there's definitely something here that has made you more vulnerable to the attack that you have experienced recently. Yes, kind of like there's meant to be a shield here. The shield is full of cracks and holes. That's how I would describe it. Okay. That does help me understand the situation going forward. So I'm going to keep going. You've definitely been thoroughly blinded I can tell we're beginning to approach the locus of the injury, but haven't quite arrived yet. Yes, there is a substantial amount of damage, and it seems to be increasing as I inspect. The heart that has faced the majority of the trauma here. Definitely the locus of this particular negative event. Okay, we're going to need a substantial amount. Unwitting individual like that. Alright, okay. So I'm going to continue to inspect further down just to make sure there isn't anything I missed. Because while it does seem like the focus of the attack is on the heart region, there might be some similar circumstances to what you had on top that might be making you more vulnerable to assaults like this. Okay. Now, I'm not really seeing anything in particular besides the damage resonating from the large central wound. Okay. I think your inspection is complete. The next step is for me to grab and remove the what I refer to spiritual weapons that have been embedded in your energy field. Yes, it's sort of, kind of think of it like porcupine quills. And each of these quills are digging into your aura and harming your mind and spirit. And so what I need to do is go in and take them out one by one. So there is quite a lot in this central heart region. And so I'm going kind of go from the outside in, from where it's least concentrated to where it's the most, to kind of thin it out. All right. So shouldn't hurt too much when I pull these out, but please let me know if you feel any discomfort or need me to stop or take a break. So, you don't answer this question if it is uncomfortable for you, but do you know where this attack may have stemmed from, or who, rather? Well, of this sort are often done as a result of jealousy, scorned lovers, for example, or people who feel like they need hopefully, if you have a little more defense in that area, then maybe things like this would not affect you, or at least would not affect you as severely. Because this is definitely a nasty, nasty little attack. And you would definitely be out of commission until this thing gets resolved. Alright, I'm beginning to center in on the heart of the problem. Definitely lots of little bitty ones. Whoever did this wanted to make it difficult to remove. But I would recommend going forward, avoiding any potentially jealousy or greed-oriented companions, because well, it is possible for something like this to come from a total stranger. Usual because of the amount of spiritual energy it requires. Generally, these things are kind of highly emotionally charged. So just think about who it is that could have negative intentions toward you, and maybe take some steps to protect yourself from them. So issues like this don't happen in the future. We're getting very close to all of these little quills being pulled away. Okay, I think I see five more. One, two, three, four, and you probably don't feel much better, but you shouldn't be feeling any worse. But in order to actually heal the wounds caused by those psychic weapons, I'm going to need to use this wand of mine. And I'm just going to, again, kind of from the outside in, just sort of seal the wounds caused by those little quills of negativity. I need to focus my healing energy into the tip of this wand. painful as I go. Alright. going to have you rest here tonight, if that's okay with you. Yes, we'll bring you anything you need. So if you become hungry or thirsty, just let us know, and we will provide you with sustenance. And I certainly don't blame you. Okay. Sleep well. I sincerely hope that you have a very